research and fact are meant to inform public debate surrounding the increasingly controversial conduct, management, and implementation of science and technology. However, in an era of abundant knowledge, facts have competition, and scientists are faced with the challenge of good communication. Knowing how to effectively communicate your research in the modern world is a key to continued interest and funding in the sciences. If you watched our previous video on presentations, the next two sections may seem like a bit of a review. However, we will talk specifically about how to apply our design principles to research posters, so please don't skip ahead. If you'd like to watch the previous video on presentations, you can find a link in the descriptions to this video below. In Design Lab, we use a critique approach to evaluating and giving feedback on media projects. We call it our CAT principles. The first part of our CAT principles is concept. This is the main idea or argument that you are trying to convey through your design. No matter what kind of project you are working on, the most important thing is that your ideas are being articulated clearly and effectively. Before you start designing your poster, you need to consider what is your goal. Are you just providing information? Are you trying to raise awareness of an issue? Are you trying to change an opinion? This will help guide your poster to depict what information is most important. You also need to consider your audience. Are they students? Are they your instructors and/or experts? What preconceptions or knowledge do they have about your topic? Additionally, you need to consider the environment. Is your poster going to be one of 10 posters on display or one of hundreds? Are you going to be standing next to your poster or will it be on display without you? If you are standing by your poster, are you going to have time to give a short spiel about it or only answer questions? Finally, you will need to consider the restrictions and expectations placed upon you. Restrictions can be things like print size and orientation, or even color, font, or template requirements. These design restrictions are common if you are working with or representing a particular organization or lab that has their own design elements. For example, if you are using the UW-Madison brand, you have to keep to a particular set of logos, fonts, and colors in your poster design. You may also have expectations placed upon you from your research partners, your advisor or mentor, or the poster session event, such as what particular elements have to be included on the poster. You'll need to make sure that you know and follow these expectations and restrictions. Aesthetics are the next principle. Aesthetics are typically a measure of visual and/or auditory quality. One aspect of aesthetics is considering the format of your project. Different forms of media have different aesthetics to take into consideration. For example, a video has different aesthetic principles than a research poster. Another aesthetic consideration for research posters is the balance of text and visuals. As we'll see from experts later, it is important to balance the text with visuals, such as images, tables, charts, and/or graphs. A 50-50 split of text and visuals is ideal, but your research and data will affect what you will include. The largest consideration for aesthetics, however, is whether or not your project is using the principles of good design. We will learn more about the principles of good design in the next section of this video. Finally, there are the technical principles of design. This includes using the right software for the job, but it also includes more abstract considerations. Is your work free of typos and errors? Are your charts, graphs, tables, and images high quality? Thinking critically about technical considerations will make your work appear more polished and professional. For a research poster, you may be using a variety of different software, such as PowerPoint, Google Slides, Keynote, Adobe InDesign, Adobe Illustrator, or Canva. It is important to use software you know or to learn the software well enough to establish an easy workflow so you can spend less time troubleshooting and more time on the content of your research poster. Check out the resources page on the Design Lab website for general software recommendations for research posters. Additionally, you'll want to make sure that the first thing you do is size your poster appropriately. Some software programs will require that you set the size before you can start working, but not all software works this way. It is a common mistake to just start designing in PowerPoint, Keynote, or Google Slides, and then realize too late that the size is not correct, which will lead to a huge headache of rearranging. Start first with the size of your poster so you can save yourself time later. Our friends at Software Training for Students can help you learn the best tools for these programs. They offer free workshops on PowerPoint and Keynote, as well as a workshop on using Adobe Illustrator to create research posters. They also offer one-on-one appointments or drop-ins in the design lab to help with the technical issues you may encounter. Coming back to aesthetics, let's talk about the principles of good design. In the Design Lab, we teach design crap. That is, we teach four principles that you should keep in mind whenever you are working on a digital media project. These are contrast, repetition, alignment, and proximity, or CRAP. That spells design. C is for contrast. Contrast can be achieved through variations in size, color, line thickness, and spacing. Designers rely on contrast to create a hierarchy of information to let the audience know what is most important. Right now, these four pieces of information are not differentiated from each other. But after we make some small adjustments, the information has a clear hierarchy. This leads the eye to prioritize the large pink information over the smaller black information. Contrast is also a function of legibility. Notice how the lack of contrast in color between the background and font makes the text difficult to read. Just by changing the background color, we can make the information much easier to understand. Further, try to avoid using images in the background, since often images will also make the text hard to read in places. Stick to simple backgrounds. One way to avoid contrast and legibility on research posters is to add bounding boxes for the text and images, as you can see here. R is for repetition. It may be tempting to throw many different colors and shapes into your design, but this can be overwhelming to your audience. Instead of trying to include too many objects of varying shapes and colors, we can use repetition of our main design element, the pink hexagon, to create a cohesive design package. This works the same with fonts. Avoid novelty or cursive fonts, which can be hard to read. Instead, stick to simple serif or sans serif fonts. You may want to use contrast to differentiate the headings of paragraph text. It is common practice to use a sans serif font for headings and a serif font for paragraph texts. However, you should use repetition throughout the paragraph and heading styles. All headings should look similar, and the same size should be used for the same heading levels. A is for alignment. Our brains want everything to be organized and struggle when things are not in alignment. Compare these lines, which are all over the place, to these lines, which are intentionally placed in alignment with one another. One of the most common errors we see in poster design is a lack of alignment. Use the rulers or guides in the software to help keep your boxes, your text, and your visuals in alignment with one another. With your text, it is most common to use left alignment or justification. Left alignment is the easiest to read and tends to look the most professional. Justification can be used, but may create large spaces in your text in places and squish words together in others. It is good practice to avoid centered text and right-aligned text. The only exception might be your title, which could be centered at the top or left-aligned. Finally, P is for proximity, which deals with the distance between elements in our design. Through proximity, we can create visual relationships that lead to an easier understanding of materials. Things that are close to each other will automatically feel more related. Proximity can also remedy some confusion. For example, when captioning images, it is important to keep the text in close proximity to said image. Even though the connections may seem obvious to you, being intentional with captions makes sure the audience can easily follow the information presented to them. You never want to give your audience an opportunity to misunderstand you. Let's hear from some experts about their experiences with research posters and their recommendations for how to successfully navigate a poster session.
Think of it more as a story with sort of here's the important things rather than here's a story about what we did.
I've actually noticed in the last couple of years the quality of posters at meetings really going up. I don't know if that's just the software is easier for people to use or they've become more comfortable with it.
What do you think is the most important element on a poster?
I would say the question is probably the most important, or the hypothesis, and then the take home.
Main questions of the project in the introduction, I think, are the most important part. Seeing, you know, why are we interested in whatever we're looking at? What are the main questions that you want to address about the organism that you're studying?
What are the most common mistakes to avoid?
Number one issue that people have is they try to put too much text on the posters. They like want to put everything in their paper on the poster. And really, ideally, it should be a about a 50-50 ratio text to images.
Bad posters are ones that have tons of text.
Be very clear about what the message is and only provide the information that gets the audience to that message.
I'm a real believer in less is more when it comes to designing posters. Putting too much words on a poster is a bit of a turnoff. Usually in a poster session, the presenter is standing next to their poster during an allotted period of time, and that's when you have a chance to fill in the gaps.
What is important to think about with regards to poster layout?
Think about where people's eyes are going to go first when they look at your poster and how you want their attention to flow.
I think of a poster as a one snapshot view of a typical scientific paper. Think of the major elements of a standard scientific paper. The abstract, which should be very brief, maybe even just a few sentences. A very brief discussion, again, it could even be two or three bullet points. Very briefly, the materials and methods. And then the results are really, you know, what you're probably wanting to showcase. And that can be done through a visual, through a chart, through a graph. And then maybe not so much discussion, but conclusion or next steps that might be taken in that project. Just tell me what this study is about. What's the goal? That's enough.
How do I get someone to come look at my poster?
So the poster itself has to hook the person in, because people wander up and down the aisles looking at, they browse these posters, and you want them to stop at yours. Maybe you engage eye contact somehow and smile, and then they might stop and look.
You want people to look at your most important information first, and that is why your title is going to be largest at the very top of your poster, and that should like grab people's attention first. But of course, the thing that somebody looks at very, very first thing is probably going to be an image on your poster.
Having lots of figures that show the results, you can have two or three really good figures and then a few sentences about those figures. And I just think that pictures, you know, say 1,000 words.
As part of trying to be really clear about the message, visuals are way more than 1,000 times more important than text. It's not just pictures 1,000 words, it's a lot more than that.
How should I talk to someone who comes to my poster?
Reading your audience is really crucial.
When you're actually talking to people at the poster, it's a very good idea to find out why they're interested in your poster, find out if they have any previous experience, so that you can sort of tailor talking to them so that you're on the same page in terms of what their background information is. At the very least, you have to remember where you started yourself, because everybody else is at least at that point.
Well, hi, let me introduce you. My name is so-and-so, and what's your name? Where do you come from?
Finally, what are some tips about ethos that we should consider?
You want to be understandable. Like, your job is not to impress somebody. Your job is to explain your work. And it doesn't matter whether you're a scientist or whatever your position in life is. Like, to use your knowledge as a way to distance yourself from someone or make yourself seem more important is doing everyone a disservice.
This is your chance to advertise your work, to reach out, to network. And nowadays people walk around with smartphones and take pictures of people's posters. So you want to make sure your name and your address and email are on there.
Let's recap. In this video, we looked at the cat of effective design. That is, concept, aesthetic, and technical elements of a research poster. We also looked at design prep, contrast, repetition, alignment, and proximity. These aesthetic principles should be taken into consideration when creating a research poster. Finally, we heard from experts about how to create and present an effective research poster. There will be a summary list of key points from these experts at the end of this video. We hope that you will apply these helpful tips in the creation of your research poster. Design Lab is here to help you work effectively in digital media. Design Lab is a free resource for students, faculty, and staff to get assistance on the design of digital projects. We are located in College Library's Computer Lab on the second floor. We offer free one-on-one or small group appointments to provide personalized recommendations and feedback on digital projects, including posters, presentations, videos, podcasts, and more. We can help you brainstorm ideas, think through the creation process, recommend tools and resources, as well as be a second set of eyes throughout the creation and editing process. We encourage you to make an appointment with one of our Design Lab consultants to get personalized feedback and recommendations for your poster. Just go to the Design Lab website and click the pink Make an Appointment button. Please feel free to also visit our resources page on the Design Lab website for links to online stock images and other content, as well as links to software help and Design Lab's own poster on posters example. Thanks for watching!